Did you know that white-tailed deer are extremely agile? They can jump as high as 3 meters and as far as 9, and sprint up to 48 kilometers per hour. I'm your host, Romi Castagnino, and I'm a conservation scientist, writer, and photographer. Every episode, we'll be introducing you to new animals caught on camera traps around the world.
And we're getting some footage from Mongabay.
These are some of the extents we take to get our SD card.
Forget to subscribe to Mongabay to get notifications about our latest videos. A white-tailed deer is a medium-sized mammal that lives in all of the Americas, from Canada to Peru and Bolivia in the south. This footage was taken in South Dakota in the United States. White-tailed deer gets its name from the white hair on the underside of the tail. When the deer senses danger, it raises its tail, showing the white patch. This is called flagging. The color on the rest of its body changes depending on the season and its location, but it is usually grayish-brown in winter and reddish-brown in summer. Males are the only ones that grow antlers, and they shed them every single year. They begin to grow them in early spring, and by late summer, their antlers are fully grown. The deer can be active at any time, but it is typically crepuscular, meaning it's most active during dawn and dusk. During these times, it browses on most available plant foods, from leaves and alfalfa to fruits and lichens. White-tailed deer are able to feed on this wide variety of food, thanks to their stomachs. Just like cows, their stomachs have 4 compartments that allow them to process food more efficiently than other mammals. White-tails are polygynous, and during mating season, bucks fight each other for their right to mate with other does in the area. As a general rule, a female in her initial year of breeding will usually give birth to 1 fawn. However, in the following years, she will more likely have twins. Fawns can walk as soon as they are born, but mothers have to leave their offspring hidden amongst vegetation while they go to find food. Fawns have spotted coats that provide them with natural camouflage, which keeps them safe from predators. Around 4 weeks old, the fawn starts to follow its mother when she goes off to forage. When males are about 1 year old, they will leave their mothers, but females will often stay with them for 1 more year. Throughout their range, the natural predators of white-tailed deer includes wolves, coyotes, mountain lions, bears, American alligators, and jaguars. If they have to, they will even escape from predators swimming through large bodies of water. They're actually pretty good swimmers. White-tailed deer can live up to 14 years in captivity, but in the wild, they usually don't make it to that age because of disease, hunting, and car collisions. They usually live around 4 to 5 years. They are listed as least concern by the IUCN. In the next episode, we'll be meeting a primate that gets its name from its short, hairless tail. Tell us in the comments if you know what animal it is. See you next time.
Mongabay.